come out.
Hey guys, welcome to another video where I do my makeup and neglect my hair. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing my must-have makeup brushes with you. This was a requested video for me to do, and I totally understand why. I have seen so many makeup brush videos, whether it's makeup brush must-haves or makeup brush favorites, and those videos have so many brushes in them. And I just think that's unnecessary. I think it's confusing to someone just starting out in makeup or to someone that just wears very minimal makeup. Maybe they just need the very basics. So I thought I would share with you my personal, realistic must-have makeup brushes. You guys know that I love super simple, light, glowy makeup looks. Those are my absolute favorite. 90% of the time, I'm not wearing any makeup, but that 10% of the time when I am, 90% of that time is an easy, light, glowy makeup look. Those are just my favorite. I think they're beautiful. But I did something a little bit more dramatic today, especially on the eyes, just to show you that these brushes can be used for very simple makeup looks, as well as things that are a little bit more dramatic. I have just 8 makeup brushes and a sponge to share with you guys today. All of the brushes in this video but one are Morphe brushes. I know that they've had a lot of controversy over their brushes recently. I don't really understand it because I really am a fan of Morphe brushes. That's 90% of my brush collection. I do have brushes by other brands, but I just find that I personally gravitate more towards my Morphe brushes. I personally haven't had any problems with Morphe brushes. Yeah, I've had some that shed, but I feel like all brushes shed when you've had them for a while, when you've cleaned them multiple times. I think they offer great brushes at great prices, so. My first makeup brush must-have is actually a makeup sponge. This is a beauty blender. This is my favorite kind, but I also really like the original Real Techniques sponge that's flat on one side and pointed on another. If you're not wanting to spend the full $20 on an actual beauty blender, the Real Techniques sponges are about $5, and those are really great as well. That's what I started out with. I just know that having a makeup sponge in my collection is absolutely necessary for me. When I apply liquid products, about 99.9% of the time, I'll use a beauty blender or a beauty sponge. I'll use a brush very rarely, but I definitely prefer a makeup sponge. When you wet one of these and you use it in your makeup routine for liquid products, I just think that it really helps the makeup application to go on smoother, a lot more even. I just know that my makeup personally looks a lot better, feels a lot better when I use a makeup sponge. So if you're just a very simple mascara, foundation, maybe concealer type of person, this is what I would recommend to you the most out of this video. I think these are awesome. I use this almost every single time I do my makeup. This is definitely one of my favorite makeup brushes. Moving on to some other face brushes for contour, I really like this Morphe M334 brush, and all of my brushes are dirty because I did use them to apply my makeup today. I love this brush. It has a great angle for contour. It's not too thin, it's not too thick. It just gets in the hollows of your cheek really, really well. If I'm not using a cream contour product and just using my beauty blender to kind of blend that out, this is usually the brush that I will reach for. It just makes contouring really easy. So if you just want something that's fast and easy, or maybe you're new to contouring, I definitely recommend this brush. And again, it is the Morphe M334. Next, this is my favorite brush for bronzing. I love this brush because it's super dense and it's pretty big, so I feel like it just disperses the bronzer really pretty, really naturally. It's not just like super targeted to one area. You're not just hitting your cheekbones, but you're kind of hitting like a good portion of your face like the sun would. I use this brush almost every single time I do my bronzer. If I don't use this brush, it's because I am telling myself, Mackenzie, you need to use another brush. You're using the same brushes all the time. I love this brush. This is probably one of my favorite brushes in my whole collection. I just think it applies bronzer beautifully. I think you could also use it to set your whole face with. I just love this brush. It's one of my favorite ones, and it is the Morphe E1. If you've been watching my channel for a while, you know that I'm not a huge blush fan. Usually when I do my makeup, I just go for a really bronzed, glowy look, and I'll just use bronzer and skip blush altogether. But when I do apply blush, and I did apply some today, I use the Morphe E3. I like it because it's round, but it comes to a really tapered point, and I think it just matches the cheekbones perfectly. I think the size of this is perfect for getting your cheekbones, and I think the tapered end of this helps your blush to not go on too strong. It just really applies it in a really pretty way. A lot of blush brushes come in a shape like this. This is the Morphe E4, where it's flat and it's kind of at an angle. I just think brushes like these are easy to pack on a lot of product, and since blush just isn't one of my favorite parts of my makeup routine, I want something really light and natural. I just think that the shape of the Morphe E3 with the tapered ends just fits the cheekbones really nicely. And I think that it applies product really beautifully where it's not too heavy. You can get a really natural look with this, or you can build it up and get something more dramatic. You could also use this brush for bronzer. So if you're looking for a brush that you can use for bronzer and blush, I definitely recommend this one, and it's the Morphe E3. I personally love cream and liquid highlights, and I'll just apply those with my finger or with my beauty blender. But when I am applying a powder highlight, the brush that I usually grab is the Morphe M501. I think that the size and shape of this brush is really great for highlighting. It easily fits on your cheekbones. I love that it's tapered and it kind of comes to a point. I think that allows you to get a really soft and subtle highlight look, or you can use the more dense bristles a little bit farther down the brush to get a stronger application, but I find that the end of it really allows you to blend your highlight really well. Next, I love stippling brushes. I don't use them every time I do my makeup, but I really do suggest having a stippling brush in your collection. This is the e.l.f. Small Stipple Brush. I've had this one for a really long time. It's broken, but it's just my favorite. I have other ones in my collection, but this is the one that I like the most. These type of brushes are great for blending your products out, so I'll use it to blend my contour out. Those times where you go in a little heavy-handed with your blush or your bronzer, these are great to kind of brush some of that away, blend out the edges. I think having at least one stippling brush in your collection is gonna make your life a lot easier. They're awesome for just blending out products. The last three brushes that I have to share with you are all eyeshadow brushes. These three brushes are the brushes that I use almost every time I do my eyeshadow. They work great for simple everyday makeup looks. I use them for this more dramatic smoky look today. I just think they're really universal, and these are the three that I reach for all the time, so they're the ones that I wanted to share with you. The first one is the Morphe M330. I use this brush to set my eyes, and then this is the blending brush that I always use to apply transition shades to my crease. It's really soft, it's tapered just the right way, it has just the amount of density to really pack on product into the crease, but blend it out really well. I always use this brush for my transition shades in the crease. If I'm doing a really simple look, I'll use this brush for all over the lid. I think this is a really universal brush, but this is an awesome blending brush. And again, it was the Morphe M330. The next eyeshadow brush that I use all the time is the Morphe M441. You can see the size difference in these. This one is a lot softer and a lot more tapered than this one. This one is still tapered, but it's a lot more round. I will use this one to start applying some colors lower in my crease and also on the outside and the inside of the lid. This brush is less soft and a little more dense, so it keeps the product a lot closer to where you apply it, whereas this one blends it out a lot more and gives it kind of a smooth blended look. This one is going to keep the product a lot closer to where you apply it. So this one, I'll apply my first transition shade, maybe two transition shades, and then when I'm wanting to keep a color from my crease down or maybe just closer to my lid, I will go in with this brush, apply it on the outer corner, blend it into my lower crease. And then for like a halo eye, something like that, I will also apply the color to my inner corner and then blend that in the crease as well. So this brush is a little bit more dense. It keeps a little bit more of the pigment, and it's great for applying colors to your lower crease and the outer and inner corners. The last brush that I have to share with you looks very similar to the M441. It is the M443, and it's just a little smaller than the M441. You can see the size difference there. This one is great for putting color on your outer corner, maybe the inner corner if you're doing a halo eye, and then buffing color just into the crease or just below the crease. It's a lot more dense, it's smaller, so it's gonna allow you to keep the product lower. So when you're applying darker shades, you don't want them to go up as high, you want them to stay kind of from your crease down. This brush is smaller, so it will do that. So I will just apply the darker shades with this brush. I applied the dark brown with this brush and then buffed out the edges. And then I went back and grabbed the M441, buffed out a little bit higher, and then I'll go back in with the M330, maybe with my first transition shade on it, and buff out the edges at the top. That's how I use these three brushes. These are the ones that I use all the time, and I think that they're great brushes whether you want to do a natural makeup look or something a little more smoky, a little more dramatic. I think that these are great. Those are my makeup brush must-haves. Those are the brushes that I use 90% of the time when I'm doing my makeup. Of course, there are hundreds of other brushes that you could have in your collection that might be a little bit better for certain things that you're going for. But if you're looking for overall just must-have makeup brushes to get you from natural makeup looks to more glam smoky looks, these are the ones that I recommend. These are the ones that I love, that I use personally. I have tons of other brushes in my collection, and these are the ones that I use 90% of the time. I personally can use 8 brushes and a beauty blender and be fine and be happy with that, and I think my makeup looks great. I don't have any problems with that. So I personally think that you can use a lot less makeup brushes than maybe what some other people might recommend. So if you're looking for the bare minimum, what you need to have in your collection, maybe you're wanting to repurchase some brushes and you don't know where to start, or maybe you're just getting started in makeup and you just want to have the bare minimum. I hope that this helped you out. All the brushes that I mentioned in this video will be listed in the description box down below if you want to check those out. I hope that if you're in the market for some new makeup brushes, that this video was really helpful. I hope that you enjoyed it, and remember, you are beautiful, you're a blessing, and I am so thankful for you. Bye! Today I'm going to walk you through step by step how I did my own lash lift or lash perm and lash tint at home.